Four way I am going to tell, that is 1 by 3. We have to subtract 1 by 3 from 2 upon 5. Okay. So we have return 2 upon 5 minus 1 by 3. This is clear. Now see here. Okay. Other way I am going to tell. We can rewrite it as 2 by 5 plus additive inverse of 1 by 3. Additive inverse of 1 by 3. Understood this one? This is the other way the book has done. So I'm just you must be aware of this way as well. Okay. So what will be the additive inverse of 1 by 3? 2 by 5 plus minus 1 by 3. It is same way. No difference. It will be now further you can solve. Okay. This is the way book has also done. Okay. So you must be aware of this way as well. Additive inverse of 1 by 3 we are taking. It will be minus 1 by 3. So plus minus 1 by 3 we can write. Okay. Moreover, we follow our method. Okay. This you have understood? If we are subtracting any number, it means we are adding a additive inverse of that number. Okay, just for understanding. Okay, so equation is clear. No doubt till now.
No, sir.
Okay, and I think you most of the students have completed. So I'm going to ask 5 students today to submit the work. Okay. Okay, so 9th question we start. 9th question we start. So verify, we are going to verify 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4. So in verification or proofs, always take left hand side, then right hand side. Now check whether they are equal or not, then prove. Okay, always remember this one. The same method we will follow always. Not equal to 1 by 4. Minus 1 by 3. What is this? It is like A minus B, B minus A. And they are not equal. It means it is commutative property on difference, on subtraction. Commutative property we apply. We are say doing first A minus B, then B minus A. Then we are proving that are they equal or not. So here we can see commutative property does not hold on subtraction. Okay. So how to prove? This is our left hand side, this is right hand side. So we take left hand side first. Okay, we take left hand side first. Left hand side is 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4. Take the LCM. What will be the LCM? 12.
12.
You must be aware of how to take the LCM. If any student who do not know how to take the LCM, do take 6th class book. Okay, try to arrange 6th class book. In that, basics are given for LCM, HCF. Please go through them. They are very important. Okay. So 3, 4 is a 12. So what are you writing here? 4. 3, 4 is a 12. So 1 into 4. 4, 3 is a 12. So here 3. And what answer we have got? 4
1 upon
12. This is our first answer. This is our answer 1. You can write here 1 or answer 1 as well, no issues. Now take right hand side. One by 4 minus 1 by 3. Take the LCM again, 12. And here we have 3 minus 4. This time how much we are getting?
Minus 1 upon 12.
Minus 1 upon 12. This is our second answer. Now check whether answer 1 is equal to answer 2. Answer 1 is 1 by 12. It is minus 1 by 12. They are not equal.
No,
so we'll write, since answer 1 not equal to answer 2. It means left hand side not equal to. Therefore, left hand side not equal to right hand side. Or we can say 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4. Not equal to 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3. And hence verified. Hence,
LHS is not equal to RHS.
Yes, not equal to. I make mistakes sometimes, so do let me know. Figure out, okay? So left hand side not equal to right hand side. And we can say 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 not equal to 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4. See, so what we have proved? Commutative property does not hold on subtraction. Commutative property does not hold on subtraction. But on addition, it holds. In addition, commutative property holds. In subtraction, commutative property does not hold. As well, you can see with very simple example. 5 minus 3. Is it same as 3 minus 5? It is not same. No. So commutative property does not hold on subtraction. When we subtract two numbers, we cannot change their order. This is clear to everyone? Okay. Second one, do as homework. We'll start with third. Okay. Associative property also will check. Okay. Associative, whether associative property holds on subtraction or not. So write the number, take the left hand side, solve the left hand side, take the right hand side, and solve the right hand side. Start doing everyone, and I'll follow you. Sorry. Okay. So question is 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 5. 1 by 2. Okay, light in the light. Also. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 5. 1 by 2 minus 3. Okay, your brackets must be large bracket. Don't put smaller ones like this only. Okay, it must be clear that this is our one group. 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 5. Okay, so we will be taking first left hand side and we'll be solving left hand side. So take left hand side 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4. So what we are going to solve first? First bracket we have to solve. See, we have associative, this is associative property, and we will check whether it holds true for subtraction. So here is one association. This is the association we have made. So first we'll be solving within the group. Okay. 1 by 2 minus, and take the LCM. It is like first we'll fight within the 15. Group, then any outsider will fight. Okay. It will be 15. And what you have to write in numerator?
5 minus 3.
Solve this one. Minus, it will be 2 upon 15. Okay, take the LCM again. What will be the LCM?
30.
So here it will be 15 minus how much?
2.
2 or something else?
4.
4, 15, 2 ja, so 2 into 2, 4. And how much we have got?
9 upon 30.
30. This is our first answer. Okay. Now solve right hand side. Right hand side. Each one solve in your notebook without looking at the board. 1, 3. In bracket minus 1 upon 5. So what will be the LCM? 6, 3 minus 2 minus 1 upon 5. It will be 1 upon 6 minus 1 upon 5. Now take the LCM again. This time LCM will be
30.
Okay, I'm writing here. 30. And what will be in numerator? Minus 6. How much each one have got?
Minus 1 upon
30.
minus 1 upon 30. So this is our second answer. Left hand side answer, first one. Right hand side answer, second one. Are they equal? Check them.
No, sir.
Only denominator is same. No, numerator is different. That means they are not same. So we'll write since answer one not equal to answer second. It means left hand side. Therefore, left hand side not equal to right hand side. Or we can say 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 in bracket with 1 by 5. Not equal to 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 upon 5. So what property we have proved? That associative property does not hold true. It does not hold true over subtraction. In subtraction, associative property is not followed. So in subtraction, commutative property is not followed. Associative property is not followed. Okay. So hence, verified. This is clear. Okay. So ninth, second also, you do as homework. Second one will be homework. Okay. Second one will be your homework. This question you have understood? Anyone have doubt? So, okay, no. First we discuss addition. Addition, in addition, commutative property holds true. Associative property holds true in addition. Okay, but in subtraction, commutative property does not hold. Associative property does not hold in subtraction. This is clear? This must always be clear, okay? Okay, now do the next one. Read the next question. Try to understand what we have to do in next question. Now what problems we have? So read them.
Sir, ninth question. Fourth one is also homework.
Fourth one is also homework. Second and fourth you have to do as homework, okay? And up to 8th, you are already done. I'll be asking 5 students today. Randomly, I'll select 5 students and they have to submit the work by 2 p.m. Just click the pic and send me on WhatsApp. Okay, 9th, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th. Now 10th A we are doing. Read the 10th A question. Read the statement. The sum of two rational numbers is minus 3 by 4. Sum of two rational numbers. That is, this is our first rational number plus second rational number. Equal to how much? Sum of two rational numbers is minus 3 upon 4. This is given in first statement. Sum of two rational number is minus 3 by 4. Okay. If one of the rational number is minus 28 upon 3. If one of the rational number is minus 28 upon 3. And the other rational number we have to find. Other rational number we have to find. This is the question. One rational number is minus 28 upon 3. And the result is minus 3 by 4. This second rational number we have to find. So other rational number. So we'll suppose. Let the other rational number be x. Okay, we have supposed the other rational number is x. Now the statement, what will be the equation we can write from the statement? Minus 28 upon 3 plus x equal to minus 3 upon 4. This is the equation we can write. Everyone have understood? Sum of two rational number is minus 3 by 4. Sum of two rational number is minus 3 by 4. This is given. And x we have to calculate. So next step, what we are going to do?
Minus 28 upon 3 minus 3 upon 4.
No. So see here what we are going to do. Left hand side, this number. We are going to shift it to right hand side. We are going to shift it to right hand side. So here it is minus.
Plus.
Here it will become
plus. Plus.
Because left hand side, all the unknown quantities will keep on left hand side. All the known on right hand side. So next step will be x equal to minus 3 by 4. It will be plus 28 upon 3. Understood this one? We are shifting minus 28 upon 3 to right hand side and it will become plus. Or more one step you can write as well. This here, it will be minus minus 28 upon 3. I skipped that step. No need of that one now. This here, understood? Anyone have doubt here? Now, all the unknown quantities are on left hand side, all the known on right hand side. Now we can solve them. Now solve them, take the LCM and solve. So what will be the LCM?
12.
Okay. So what will be here?
Minus 9.
How much?
112.
112. Okay.
Is equal to 103 upon 12.
103
upon 12.
Well, is there any factor? Common factor? No. 3. It's not divisible by 3. We cannot solve further. So this is our answer. So what is the other number? The other number is this one you have to write, the last statement. The other number is 103 upon 12. If you want to check what, how you can check, put it here 103 upon 12, add them. If you are getting the same answer, it means your solution is correct. Value for x is correct. You can check that way as well. In examination, if you have got the time, you can check it. Put that number here, add these two numbers and see whether you are getting minus 3 by 4 or not. That you can do for checking purpose. This, anyone who haven't understood? Okay, second one, do it now. Everyone do it in your notebook. I'm giving you 2 minutes. Second one, everyone do it in your notebook. The same way you have to do. Read the question, 2 rational number is this. If 1 rational number is this, find the other. Do it now. So steps must be there in your notebook. And always write the steps. Everyone keep doing the second one. Read the question first very clearly. Again, the sum of 2 rational numbers is minus 3. This time, sum result is minus 3. If one of the number is 7 upon 8, we have to do. So the other number will suppose, again, let other number be x. We have supposed that one. So the equation will become 7 upon 8 plus x equal to minus 3. Okay. Everyone have got the correct equation?
Yes, sir.
Yes, good. Now, 7 upon 8 from left hand side will take it to right hand side. Move it to right hand side. So here it is in plus sign. So it will become here they minus. Added, here it will be subtracted. Take it to right hand side. X equal to minus 3 minus 7 upon 8. Now you can solve. You all are smart kids. You can solve.
Sir, 8 will be LCM.
It will be LCM. So how much it will become numerator? 24.
Minus 31 upon 8.
So next line, what you are going to write? The other number is in question C, you find the other. So you have to write the other number is, because examiner do not know what is X. So we have to tell him that the other number is minus 31 upon 8. So the other number is minus 31 upon 8. And always take care of negative sign. Don't forget negative sign or you will make mistake. Okay. Now do the next one. Do it yourself. Read the next one. 11th A part. Okay, 11th A, you can do as homework. Okay, 11th A, you do. B, do as homework. Okay. 11th A, do it. What number should be added to minus 11 upon 4 to get? So minus 11 upon 4 plus x equal to 2. Minus 25 upon 40. Okay, before this you will write, let the other number be added be x. Let the other number added equal to x or be x. Then we can write the equation. See here, you can write it as also, whether you either you write the equation like this or x plus minus 11 upon 4 minus 25 upon 40. Both the equations are correct. Both the equations are same because addition follows commutative law. So we can write this way also. We can write this way also. No issue with that. And why we are able to write in both ways? Because addition follows commutative property. Whether you write 5 plus 2 or 2 plus 5, they will be same. So you can write either this way or this way. Both the equations are correct. So never get confused in exam whether I have to write for x first or this one first. Addition follows commutative law, so we can write it either way. Now solve them. Take it on right hand side. Minus 11 upon 4, minus 25 upon 4. So x will be minus 25 upon 14 minus, it will become plus 11 upon 4. Take the LCM, what will be the LCM? Good. So what is going to come in numerator?
Minus 50
plus
77.
4, 7, so 11, 7, 77.
27 upon 28.
So the other number added is 27 upon 28. Anyone who have doubt? Okay, good. No. Do the 12th first. Do the 12th A. Today we'll complete this exercise. Read the question first. Are we adding or subtracting? Read it first. What number must be subtracted from minus 7 upon 8 to get minus 5 upon 12? So it is saying what number must be subtracted from minus 7 upon 8, we have to subtract that number. So minus 5 upon 12. This is the question saying what number must be subtracted from minus 7 upon 8 so that we get minus 5.12. Okay, read the statement very carefully in subtraction. What number must be subtracted from minus 7 upon 8 so that we get minus 5.12? This is the statement given. So let the number subtracted be x. So what will be the equation? Minus 7 upon 8 minus x equal to minus 5.12. Solve it, everyone. You have 1 minute to solve this one. You can solve it fast as well. So there are many ways to solve this one. Yes, there are many ways to solve this one. Either you can take this on right hand side or x on right hand side, this on left hand side. Okay, we are moving with simple. This one I'm moving to right hand side first. So here it will be minus x. Minus x will be remaining. Minus 5 upon 12 plus 7 upon 8. This so will be on this slide.
To minus 10 plus 21 upon
20. Okay, let's solve. Okay, minus x equal to how much? What will be the LCM here? 24. 24, good.
24.
So 12, 2 jump. So minus 10, minus 8, 3 is 21. Minus x will be how much?
11 upon
24. 11 upon 24. So x will be how much?
Minus 11 upon 24.
Minus 11 upon 24. You can see here, minus x equal to 11 upon 24. So x will be minus sign we are taking on right hand side now. So minus 11 upon 24. So we have got the number minus 11 upon 24. So the number subtracted equal to minus 11 upon 24. You can as well put it here. You can check your answer as well. If you go to the time in examination, you can put this number here. You can check it. This checking part, always do it afterwards when the paper is over. Okay. B part. Okay. B part do as homework. What number? Okay. Write the equation and we will see the equation. Solve it as homework. So what will be the equation written here? What number should be subtracted from 1 to get? So we are getting what number must be subtracted from 1? What number must be subtracted from 1 so that we get 7 upon 17 and minus sign is, okay, in between it is written. Here you write or here you write, it is fine. So let that number be x. The equation will be 1 minus x equal to minus 7 upon 17. And you have to solve for x. Okay. Do that as homework. Do that as homework. What number should be subtracted from? What number should be subtracted from 1? So that we can get equal to sign minus 7 upon 17. Okay, now we do the 13th one. Identify the true statements only. Okay, so first one, everyone read first one. Try to understand. Everyone read first one. The sum of two rational number is a rational number. Is it true? Sum of two rational number is always a rational number. Which property it is? Closure property. closure property it is closed. That is, if I adding two rational number, we always get a rational number. Okay, second one, the difference of two rational number is not always a rational number. Is it true or false?
True.
Difference of two. It's false. Take any two rational number. 5 is rational number, 2 is rational number. If we subtract, we are getting 3. Take any two numbers, you get always a rational number. So addition and subtraction, they follow closure property. They follow closure property. That is, whether we add two rational number, whether we subtract two rational number, we always get a rational number. This is clear. 0 is not a rational number. True or false? 0
false.
Is not a rational. It is
false.
0 is false. A rational number. It can be expressed in the form of 0 by any other non-zero number. 1 or 0 by plus 12, plus 13, minus 12, anything we can write. It's a rational number. Always remember, 0 is a rational number. Addition is commutative or rational number. So
true.
Commutative property holds true for rational number. Subtraction is commutative or rational number. Subtraction, that is 5 minus 2 equal to 2 minus 5. Is it true or false? It
false.
Is false. Does not hold. So commutative property, associative property, they hold true for addition. Addition, they hold true. But for subtraction, they do not hold true. Okay. Addition is associative on rational numbers. True or false?
True.
True. Subtraction is associative on rational numbers.
False.
It is false. False. Zero is the additive inverse of itself.
True.
It's true. If we add 0 to 0, we get 0. So 0 is additive inverse. 0 is the additive identity for rational numbers.
True.
True. We add 0 to any number, we'll get the same number. So it's their identity. 1 is the additive inverse of minus 1.
True.
Minus 1 is there, it's the additive ninth. Inverse plus 1. 0 we get. So?
9th.
Yes. 9th one. 9th one, 0 is the additive identity for rational number. It's true. Okay, any number you take plus 0, you will always get the same number. 5, we get 5. Minus 5, we get minus 5. Minus 5 upon 2, we get minus 5.2. So 0 is the additive identity of rational numbers. Okay, clear? So we have done exercise first day. Okay, so I'm selecting 5 students. They have to send the work. Okay.